In order to harness wind power effectively, wind turbines in mountainous areas are typically installed on elevated terrain, far from densely populated regions. This makes transporting wind power equipment a specialized and challenging task. This 94-meter-long wind turbine blade is on the final leg of a long journey. But given the narrow and winding roads that it will traverse and the nature of the cargo, getting there is a slow and cumbersome process. Assembled in neighboring Hunan province and piggybacked through city streets, expressways, and mountain roads, the giant blade will have traveled 600 kilometers by the time it reaches its final destination in Shichuan County, Guizhou province.
我的名字叫王四静，周岁是五十五周岁了，跑这个货运行业是从98年到今年的23年。因为我们这个拉风电，它属于特种车辆，它还超重，还超长超宽。第一次来贵州就是03年，那全部走的那国道，国道就拐不了弯，有时候最厉害的一上一下一个坡，最长的就有时候差不多要一天时间。
The people of Guizhou often refer to their province's rapid development as the Golden Decade, a period when its transportation network underwent major expansion. From 2012 to 2021, Guizhou's highway mileage grew from 2,630 kilometers to 8,010, making it the first province in Western China to connect every county with a highway. Since then, nothing has seemed out of reach. Since he opened his own farm stay, Ma Su in June has been proudly educating his guests about the Beipon River Bridge soaring above them. After quitting his job in 2018 and transforming his home into a farm stay, Ma Xuanjun's life never seems to have a dull moment.
<音><音> 弄完了是吧？好的好的，我马上修一下桥，我就过来跟你交个接，好吧？
The rope bridge at the village entrance has always been the only crossing. Over the years, it has gradually fallen into disrepair. Ma Su and Jun has taken the initiative to maintain it himself.
That 木板啊，这些都是我自己买来的，还有维护啊，上面螺钉啊，还有那些打油啊，这些很多人都说，哎呀，你天天有这么好的精力去修啊，我说我们不修就没路走了，我们一定要把这个路修好，修好以后人来多啊，大家都好。
Ma Su and Jun has also taken it upon himself to carve out a small path from the mountainside.So guests can visit a nearby waterfall.
So we also use our own small power to change the road. We hope more people come. If people come, they come here to buy a bottle of water, buy some shoes, buy a swimming trunk, go play. Everyone has money to spend. So we have to contribute our small power. We can do it with all our might, all our efforts to do it.
那儿子，秀才，洗得满满哈，听没有？你看到那里有个小瓶瓶，前面有些垃圾的捡哈。开始捡，好，慢慢哈。哎呦，有些地方你别看，捡不到地方你看看哈。
Since the Bay Pond River Bridge's construction, Ma Xuanjuan's life has never been better.He strongly believes that to secure a happy future for his family, he must begin teaching his son the importance of protecting his hometown now. Thanks to the convenience, economic benefits, and fair amount of celebrity, the world-class bridge is brought to the area. The people now have more confidence in the direction. Their hometown is trending than ever before. Naturally, world-class bridges require world-class maintenance.
这个4月19日上午8点，它这个当前公分值达到了80这个毫，所以这个要注意加强观测。
To ensure the Bay Pond River Bridge fulfills its purpose, a comprehensive health monitoring system was installed. Every cable.Steel truss and bolt is under precise surveillance, while measurements of vibration and sway, however minor, are recorded and analyzed in detail. Meanwhile, high-definition cameras scattered along Guizhou's highways provide real-time surveillance of their roads, bridges, and tunnels. Even a small pothole,Just 0.01 square meters in size can be detected by their AI systems.
现场采集车采到的一个病害的信息，并且它的一个定位是厘米级的。同时，我们可以现在看得到，它将病害的一个长宽高，还有它的分布情况、裂纹情况都进行了一个采集，并且将它数字化。然后呢，我们将这些病害信息通过一个数据汇总。然后将它的位置，然后详情，这样推送给我们的管理单位。
This scaled digital model is capable of monitoring and analyzing the bridge's health data in real time. The state-of-the-art system also simulates various extreme weather and environmental conditions, so the team can prepare for almost any eventuality. Another undeniable benefit these roads and bridges have brought to the depths of the mountains is attention. During the week-long National Day holiday, waves of tourists flow in from all directions to fill their curiosity and see the world record holder for themselves. In this village, the loquats and mulberries are ripe. On the first day of a Labor Day holiday, a grandfather is taking his grandsons out early to sell their harvest. While many children from the deep countryside may not have had the chance to leave their hometown yet, that doesn't mean the outside world can't come to them.
来，干脆光过来。
Since the Pingtang Bridge opened at the end of 2019, it has become the newest attraction in the vicinity of the Tianyin, China's 500-meter aperture spherical radio telescope. The bridge, with its futuristic design and three 300-meter towers, has become a popular tourist attraction itself, necessitating the construction of its own service area and viewing platform. In addition to the usual amenities, the site features a hotel, museum, camping area, as well as the observatory itself. Now a lively tourist destination during holidays, the Sky Bridge Service Zone showcases the otherwise remote region's modern capabilities while allowing villagers to set up stalls and sell their local goods and crafts, adding to the area's exquisite charm. Long Jinbiao still remembers the loneliness of having his parents work away from home and refuses to allow his son to go through the same experience. That's why the year the bridge construction began, he decided to give up his high-paying job in Zhejiang province to return home. Recognizing how lucky he is to have such an opportunity, he is determined to make the most of it. Business may be booming today, but that wasn't always the case. Long Jinbiao readily acknowledges that before gaining experience in large-scale agriculture, he made quite a few mistakes along the way. In response to China's rural revitalization initiative, a construction road was widened and paved between nearby Ping Liher village and the bridge's service zone. Now, Long Jinbiao's fruits can be transported directly from his trees to his stall, and the local children have a fun place to visit during their school holidays.
This is the
给我们全国乃至世界的这个来旅游的这些朋友们。
Aside from bringing in scores of tourists and boosting the local economy, the bridge has helped reunite families that were once separated by work commitments elsewhere. Now, there is an infectious buzz around town, as everyone is eager to get in on this virtually unspoiled treasure. Many of Guizhou's bridges are painted in red, the most auspicious color in China. But as more of these world-class bridges are being built, China is showing a willingness to branch out, taking bridge aesthetics to a whole new level. There are also blue bridges, yellow ones, and even pink. No matter their color, they are all breathtaking in their own right, especially when it comes to their complex and purposeful designs. For instance, the Huahua Bridge allows vehicles to make a convenient U-turn, as does the Hejiang Interchange, which, with its three-tier structure and over 300 piers, rises more than 200 meters to connect to the Bijia Waning Expressway. Yet it's not just Guizhou's highways that soar to such impressive heights and lengths. On August 8, 2023, the Libo station of the Guiyang-Nanning high-speed railway opened, creating a new land-sea corridor between Guizhou, the Beibu Gulf, and ASEAN countries. Along with the previously completed Chengdu-Guiyang, Guiyang-Guangzhou, and Chongqing-Xinjiang high-speed railways, Guizhou's rapid transit network now stretches in all directions. The Jinfeng-Wujiang River Bridge is a key project on the Guiyang-Jinsha-Guilin Expressway. Thanks to Beidou positioning and digital assembly technology, each of the 650,000 high-strength bolts used in this bridge's construction have been precisely installed and will not require readjustment. Once completed, it will become the fastest highway link between Guizhou's capital of Guiyang and Chengdu, the capital of Sichuan Province. The most aesthetically pleasing bridge in Guizhou has to be the Jinfeng-Wujiang River Bridge because of how well it blends with the surrounding scenery. In fact, its turquoise color matches so perfectly with river below that some people have taken to calling it Wujiang Blue. Li Zhao and Qin Guifeng, a husband and wife engineering team, met in university where they both majored in civil engineering. Now they work for the same company and have become well accustomed to working on large-scale construction sites. Just before the bridge's final inspection, the couple is invited to a national bridge conference where they will both give speeches.
如果我已输快了，你在下面给我打个手势，打个信号。没事的，没问题的，经常讲课的。After
19 years working in the same industry, both of them have participated in several bridge projects. However, this is the first they've led as a team. Initially, Qin Guifeng was the chief engineer overseeing its construction. But when she was transferred to a new role at the General Engineering Office, Li Zhao took over. While no longer chief engineer, Qin Guifeng frequently checks in on the bridge's progress. In the coming days, the bridge will undergo its final load test before opening to traffic, and she insists on being there to witness it.
就是有的时候肯定会出现，某一方会强势一些哈，某一方会听另外一方的，这样这个没问题，这个只要但我们坚持的是我们的原则问题。
Given how much time the two spend together, arguments are inevitable. But Li Zhao has learned that when Qin Guifang is insistent about something, it's for good reason. After all, work, just like marriage, is all about striving towards a common goal.
安全帽戴好。
In his capacity as chief engineer, Li Zhao must be meticulous about every detail of the bridge's construction. Similarly, as a husband, he understands his wife's deep attachment to each project she has worked on. Like their relationship, this bridge will be built to last.
看这鞋不好下山，注意点啊！
哦，
我拉你。
怎么这么快？
你
不行，我这鞋不行。等我先下水了，你再下哈。没有，接着你。
When it comes to bridge construction, it's hard to find a more synchronized team. However,Due to the demands of their work, they must often spend long periods away from their families, leading to a sense of guilt. But after all the sacrifices, there is always an immense payoff when the job is complete.
就是一种自豪感吧，从无到有，一座高速又在贵州产生了。
现在我们感觉到能把它如此高精度、高质量的、高标准的把它完成了，把它能交付出去，说出来的自豪感和满足感，这是我们工程人和桥梁人最大的一种幸福。
To test the bridge's load capacity, 48 35-ton trucks line up in ceremonial fashion. At this point, this is just a formality, but it is a neat way to celebrate the occasion. Soon, the Jinfeng Wujiang River Bridge will officially become one of the over 30,000 bridges across Guizhou. With its massive collection of towering bridges and vast network of highways,Guizhou itself has become a bridge in the heart of southwestern China, creating endless possibilities for regional economic development. It has been said that these bridges connect not only two sides of a mountain or one bank of a river to another, but also Guizhou's past.Present and future. Despite its precipitous terrain and the seemingly insurmountable challenges it has had to overcome, many of its most remote and hard to get to areas are now part of a wonderfully intricate high-speed network. Today, this network is a key artery for southwestern China, driving Guizhou into a bright new future of revitalization.